Shivai Sharma, and welcome back on InfoHub Media once again. So today I'm going to be speaking with Harish, who is doing his PhD from IIM Ahmedabad in OB area, and his interesting story will help us understand how he prepared, which sources he used to get in the prestigious IIM Ahmedabad. So let's welcome him. Hi, Harish.
Hi, Anita. It's nice to be here.
So, Harish, please tell us about your background, because it's very interesting to know that you have worked with Azim Premji Foundation, and how your previous experience helped you to design your decision towards research as a career option.
To brief my background, I am a social work postgraduate. So I did my bachelor's and master's both in social work from Bangalore University. Mm-hmm. And then I worked for a couple of years in different organizations. With the Azim Premji Foundation, I was a fellow. And then I worked with Ministry of Labour and Employment. Mm-hmm. So as you asked about Azim Premji Foundation, it was the major, part of my experience where it helped me to see a broader, a broader overview of the research and other areas. Mm-hmm. And if you ask me how it links to research, then I have multiple reasons. The first aspect is that I was always wanted to be a teacher, because teachers played a very important role in my life. They have not only given me knowledge and also food. Like one of my teacher, he used to one of my professor at my master used to give me afternoon food for 2 years.
Okay.
And I thought I should be in this profession so that I can continue that chain. So that is the one reason, from a personal friend. And then by nature, I was very curious to know about things, what is, things happening around me. Then I thought why I should not be in a profession which helps to do that all the time. So then I thought I should be in the research and academics. But I'm not sure about which area I should do. I was always interested in workplace and other things, because I have worked in different areas. My first work was in a hotel as a cleaner. I started. Then I worked in construction and different sites. Different areas. Then my last work was with the International Ministry of Labour and Employment. So there is a huge. Different areas of work experience. So I was I was always interested in knowing how dynamics work, happens at a workplace. Mm-hmm. But I was not sure whether in which area I can do. I was in social work basically. Then I thought. Then from one of my friend, I heard that I can do from IIM also. They have a OB area. Then I started my preparation from 2016.
2016.
Yeah.
Oh wow. So which exam did you prepare for, like NET JRF or GMAT or CAT? Which exam did you appear for?
NET JRF.
NET JRF in social work?
Yeah, social work.
Okay, great. Okay, so tell me, you got an invite from IIM Ahmedabad. So for the interview, and you have got close to 3 months to prepare for the interview. So how did you prepare for that?
Okay, so preparation is, the first part was gathering information for me, because I was outsider, completely outsider. I did not had any person who belonged to IIM or have studied in that area, so it was completely new. So I wanted to gain the understanding on the whole process. So then I started contacting people over the Facebook and LinkedIn. So completely unknown people, but they responded very well. Many people have responded, and they started to give me a broader understanding of the process. Then it took 2 years for me to understand the whole process. So I had been to the interview process earlier also, then I got rejected. Then I went back and then again started getting to know more about the interview process. So I used to talk to people who got selected, again contacting them over the LinkedIn and talk to them. So it was like I spoke to more than 30 to 50 people, I guess.
Okay.
To understand this, how exactly it works.
So you appeared after 2016. When did you appear for your first round of interviews and all?
2019 I have applied for IMC and IMA. Then I in IMA I got into second round also, but then I did not then I did not get selected. Then I tried again in 2020, then I got in.
So did you understand like where was the lacking in, where did you lack in 2019 and how did you prepare and overcame that aspect where you found that you were lacking?
Yeah, so I understood one is the mathematical ability because I am from social science. So that was the one giving me a trouble in interview. So then I thought of preparing that and I was fearing towards maths a lot. Then the Khan Academy came into my rescue, and then I prepared. I started to studying from 4th standard maths. From 4th to 10th, I studied from Khan Academy for this interview. And also, I by that time, I got to know that it's having maths is very important, not only for interview to sustain this coursework and also to win the research. Then I started preparation. So that was a one area. Second is presenting myself in a more better way and inclining myself towards research. So these things helped me, and also I building profile.
So what did you do to prepare your profile?
Yeah, so one was maths, and the second thing is that I tried to understand the OB area and the research around it, reading and making a more better proposal for a research. And I tried to do some co-authoring also, but that did not work out. Being outsider, it's very difficult to get a co-author, even difficult to get some papers also. But that process gave me a good understanding of the research. So I was reading myself about this all the theories and methods. So that helped me a lot. So basically it's an overall preparation. In terms of fine-tuning my motivation answers, fine-tuning my theoretical understanding. So that helps.
Okay. On a lighter note, I would like to say that here you are mentioning outsider word. I think a couple of times you have used this word. It brings this Bollywood concept of outsider a lot. Okay, so let's.
I mean, knowledge is a very important tool, right? So it will give you access to many things. Outsider insider is a very important binary perspective because having a information makes a lot of difference in your preparation and how we approach ourselves in the interview.
So let's come to your interview. So you have got a call to appear for an interview, and this time I am sure it is online interview, definitely because of the corona thing. So tell us more about your interview experience then, because you are mentioning it and you appeared for the second time as well. So how rich the interview experience is, what kind of questions are being asked? Is it too technical? As you said, it is unpredictable, but still, is it too technical? Is it too specific to research? Or what about your own personal experience on that?
I see interview in three major dimensions. One is about my motivation questions. So why I want to do PhD and how serious I am. It is not only just the words I say, they'll see from what efforts I have put in. So like for that, I have to show them what kind of readings I have done so far, how strong I am in those areas. So that helps. And when I wish to get committed for 5 years, so how serious I am about that. So these things are very important in terms of the motivation part. And the second part is about the content. Those questions were about understanding. It again varies because I had a work experience. It is majorly about the work experiences, but for the freshers, it might be in terms of their subject knowledge, but it's basically about the contents or the knowledge area. And the knowledge area is not only about knowing the information about that particular theory or the work area, it's also about its implications in a practical world. And am I capable to link that to the research area? Am I capable to draw out research questions out of my knowledge and work experience? These are the things. And the third part is skill. So the skill is basically mathematical or the statistical and the research skills. So these are the areas where we can expect questions.
Okay. And what kind of questions were asked to you? If you can be specific on these three aspects, motivation or content skills.
So regarding motivation, one very usual question, why do you want to do PhD? Mm-hmm. But then they dig more about, so, okay, you want to be, you know, you want to be an academician. So what do you do after that? So what do you become, you know, what do you do after becoming an academician? Then I say, I wish to contribute to the knowledge domain of that. Then how it helps? So what next? What next? So they'll dig more to understand how clear I am on my, you know, purpose to be here.
Mm-hmm.
This is about motivation. And the second thing about knowledge area is that either it starts with my work experience or with the, with a particular knowledge domain. So one in one interview I was asked about social movements.
Mm-hmm.
So then it is about the current theories about social movements, then how I relate that to my current work. So how did I relate that to my current work? And then the next question was that if at all you have to draw a research question, how do you draw that? And what methods you would like to use? So this is the one.
Mm-hmm.
And one interview is about the work experience. They asked me, so what are the things you want to theorize from your work?
Mm-hmm.
And if you want to have a research, then what are the areas you want to draw from your work experience? So these are the further. And regarding the skill or a mathematics part, it is basically about having understanding about particular statistical concept, correlation or the basic statistics. So then they will dig. But most of the times I was answering up to a point. Then when I understand that, then I can't go further. I used to say that I know only this much, but as because I am just saying two things. Both the things, good and bad, because it will help people. Because interview will go in different directions. In one interview, even after I am saying that I am not from math, I was asked the 12th standard question, some inequal distribution, which I don't know. But in few interviews, the most thing I liked is that when I say that I don't know this, but I know a little bit of statistics, then the questions were asked in that area.
Okay.
When I say that I don't know about the organization change, but I know about social change, then the questions were asked on that.
And so you are actually saying that your interview, you got a chance to direct your interview towards what you know in detail.
Yeah.
Okay, great. Wait, this is an interesting aspect. In fact, maybe our the future potential students can also learn from your perspective. That if you don't know one part, maybe you can direct something on which you have complete understanding about a topic or anything.
And most of the times it works.
Yeah.
It works for me most of the times. It works because they are also keen to know what I know. It is not always that they want to puzzle me. So they want to know what I know. So then then putting across things which I know will really help in terms of continuing research. And the second thing is that. Whichever concept I am wishing to explore, I should know the next 5 questions of that at least.
Mm-hmm.
And if I'm saying that I know about social movements or something else or something new to me, I should expect the 5 next 5 questions. Yeah, it was very it was a wonderful feeling because I was longing it for many years. And finally, I got it. So the first thing I did is that I was reading the email again and again. So I read it many times. I was reading again and again that, okay, because I remember the last year's email that we are sorry to say that you have been not selected. So this year I was reading it again that I have not mistaken the email. So that was the first thing I did. Yeah, to make myself sure about the result. And the second thing I did is that I called everyone. With whoever I have spoke regarding my PhD, I have spoke to many people. Then many people have guided me in terms of many different helps. So then I called everyone. Even though I had one interaction with them also, I just called them and told that I because I know in my friend circle and my family they had made my dream as their dream. So they were also equally anxious and they were excited about my coming here. So.
So how, I actually can, I have this goosebump feeling at this moment because when you're saying that my dreams are my family's dreams that's a dream come true kind of moment. Yeah, I can understand. So Harish, thank you so much. Do you have anything else to share beyond what we have discussed?
Yeah, one thing is that, what I felt is that preparation, preparation should be all round. This is what I felt.
Mm-hmm.
During my preparation, because as I told, interview is very unpredictable. It can go in any direction. So preparation, we should prepare, you know, from all directions. So if it is regarding our motivation questions, we should be very clear why why I want to spend my 5 years. And you also know, because you are a PhD, you know, graduate, you know that if I like that, it will be a very wonderful part of my life. If I don't like, then it will be a disastrous thing in my life. So I should be very clear about why I want to do PhD. And second is that preparation in terms of all areas, motivation, then content, skills, and also having a very good background information about the institute. Because after I come here, if I realize that I don't have a faculty or the area which can guide my interest areas, then it will become really difficult. So having a proper understanding about the institute and the faculties, their work is also very important to match my interest and the capacities which they serve. So these are very important. And the third thing is that it's all about trying again and again and not leaving, because it's not only about our efforts and knowledge or our understanding, it's also about many other things which are not in our hand. Institution's capacity to have students, the kind of the pool that year, appeared for the interview, the kind of our match and the institute match in terms of the research. So there are many things which is not in our hand. So we should always try again and make ourselves, with more and more better attempts.
So you are finally at your dream place. I'm very happy to learn, and I'll be keep on coming to you to learn others, success stories from you. And thank you, Harish. All the best, and God bless you.
Yeah. Thank you so much. So it was nice to talk to you. So as you said, it is always. Getting into IIM is one part of the journey. Then surviving here is a second and very important part of the journey.
Absolutely.
So it's not only about surviving; it is getting more out of here is also very important. So
absolutely.
As you said, it's one of the very rigorous journey. So definitely, helping each other and knowing from each other will definitely help. So I have been, beneficiary of that, and definitely I should continue that.
Thank you
so much for providing that platform.
Thank you so much.
Press the bell icon on the YouTube app and never miss another update.